Hey everyone, this video we are going to understand about triangular decomposition pattern under microservices architecture. So this is one of the most important patterns that we should understand properly, and this is one of the most asked interview question also. It's very easy to understand and most practical, right? So let me go ahead and show you the use case example and how we can implement it. So first talk about the use case, right? So this is our monolithic application about the product online shopping portal that I have been showing throughout the course. This triangular pattern comes only picture when you are transforming your monolithic application into microservices architecture. So initially you have this this big monolithic application, right? And now you have to convert it into microservices architecture piece by piece. So first let's take an example that I have taken this product management module, and I have converted into microservice. Code is complete, testing is complete, and it's ready to go into production, right? So I have to decide a strategy. I have to take a strategy that how I can integrate it so that user is not affected, right? So this client is requesting it, right? So if your entire application is in production, so we have to come up with a strategy that we replace this this module with this service. At the same time, user should not be affected. So let's understand this, how we can do it. This is the two component that I have taken. So this is the product management. This is the product management of our monolithic application. And this is the account management. So I am just saying that product management is being used by account management. So in account management module, there is some insertion point. There is some code written from where you are calling the product management with some inputs, and it is responding accordingly. Right now, this product management has been converted into microservices architecture, and I have to come up with a strategy at this point that whether to call this product management or new microservice that is there. Right? Let's see how we can do this. So this is the new diagram that it looks like, right? So this is the direct connection that was happening earlier, right? Now this connection have to be replaced by this. I have to come up with a route at this point, right? So this is the route, means in programming language, if I say that it is a if-else block. So this is some condition. On the basis of some condition, it is going to call the old flow, that is monolithic way. And in some condition, it is going to call the new flow, that is product management microservice that we have. So what it should be? So initially, when we are planning to make in production in product management so that it can be user can call product management services. So suppose this is the client, right? So this is the client which is calling account management. Account management is internally deciding whether to call the old flow or new flow, right? So initial strategy should be that if you are getting 100 requests, we are getting few requests. For example, 10 requests should go to the new flow and 90 requests should go to the old flow. With this 10 requests, we can monitor, we can observe the product management new flow that whether it is working as expected or not. Based on the condition, based on the result analysis, if it is going fine, we can gradually increase this percent, right? So in the second phase, we can make it 50%, right? And if everything going fine, we can make it 100%. So this flow can vary. You can make more gradual, like 10, 20, 30, and then 100. Depends on you, right? And at any point, if you feel that this flow is not working properly, you just have to reduce this percent to 0%. So then all the requests will go to the old flow. So there is no problem, right? So the point is how you implement this route. And at any time, we have flexibility to go to the old flow and new flow. And it doesn't affect the user whether it is going to the old flow or new flow. Because whatever response it was giving based on the particular request, our product management service is also giving the same response. So like the flow goes like this, right? So it goes like this. First phase is transform, identify the module which you want to convert to microservices, then coexist, means by using that route, put both old flow and new flow in combination, both are existing at the same time. By the time, eliminate the old flow and make into production the complete new flow, right? So this is what a triangular pattern is. Now coming to the point, why this is known as a triangular pattern, why this we are saying it, right? So there is this tree, there is this tree that is a strangler fig here. So what happens, this is a big tree, and these bushes that you are seeing, these are the seeds that that when they fell on the tree, they are growing from the branches of the tree to the root of the tree, right? And they start growing on the host tree. They grow on the host tree and they eliminate by the time, right? So the same phase that is here, the tree, the bush is growing on the tree. They are coexisting for some time, and by the time the bushes that were there, the new branches that are here, by the time they have eliminated the host tree itself, and all around now there are these bushes that is here, right? That is why this pattern has got the name strangler fig. So this is all about the strangler fig pattern. This is very easy to understand. So next video we are going to see about sidecar pattern. This is yet very important decomposition pattern under microservices. So we are going to see two concepts. Service mesh we are going to understand. We are going to understand sidecar. So they both of them are related, but they need separate understanding. So I am going to make separate video for each of these, right? So to get the information about complete course and all other things, check out the description box of the video, right? So I'll see you in the next video with the decomposition pattern, that is sidecar and service mesh. Till then, take care. Bye bye.